Hello everyone, I'm Chandra Mohan Garg. So before I talk about my area, sociology part of paper one and ethics, I'll try to speak some general stuff. See, the point is simple that nobody is going to judge you on what you know, but on the basis of what you deliver. And that is the golden rule in life. And same applies in UPSC. Koi nahi dekhne wala aapne 2 saal, 2.5 saal kya mehnat ki hai. Examiner is only going to judge you on what you are going to deliver in those 150 to 200 words. So you need to learn the art of writing answers. That is very important area. What I personally feel is when we are writing an answer, there are 3 important components of it. One is knowledge, second is contextual thinking and analysis, and third is articulation. Issue is ki most of us have an issue ki jab hum padh rahe hote hain to we focus only on the first part, knowledge. Padhna hai, knowledge gather karni hai. And we even don't prefer to write or practice answers because we have some phobia ki abhi to is topic pe hame zyada aata hi nahi hai. But UPSC is not looking for specialists. It's looking for generalists who have a application based mind. And hum yahi pe galti karte exams mein bhi. Say for example, question aaya tha last year ki reducing land farm sizes, how contract farming and land leasing will help. So because we have studied and we have so much of knowledge, we try to show our knowledge part, writing on the factual aspects of contract farming or land leasing. And we miss out the application part, which is actually the crux of an answer. So knowledge is, it has to be limited to an area that you are having a broader overview and an ability to have a perception on a particular topic. Next part is very important, analysis and thinking in context of the question. Because this, every question that you get is like a problem statement and you have to evaluate it properly and write according to the context. So keep your thinking birds high always. And the last and the most important area is articulation. You might be having a lot of information, but how do you portray it in 150 to 200 words is something that you have to learn and that you can only do through practicing answer writing. So don't think ki ek particular topic pe bahut zyada knowledge hogi tabhi I have to practice it. Start as early as possible as you can. I would tell 3 things that I did which helped me in doing well in my mains part was, firstly, when I joined the test series after prelims, before every test that used to take place, what I used to do was say paper 1 ya say paper 2 ka koi topic hai, polity and pabad wala part. So what I would do was ki jo static ke parts maine padhe hain aur jo contemporary parts I'm trying to cover up before this test, I would read it and whatever important topics are coming up in those areas, I would simply try to concise them as brief as possible. Say for example, if I am reading economy, usme NPA aaya, to I'll write it down, NPA ke challenges, solutions. Contract farming aaya, challenges, solutions, issues. Make in India aaya, what is it about, features, solutions, and what can be done. So like this, what I tried to do was ki during, before every test, जो भी syllabus का part है उसका current और static के जो भी important topics हैं उसमें मैं brief points बना लूँ, 4-5 pros, cons and what can be the solutions. And I was able to revise them twice or thrice, so all important topics were there in my mind. And exam is very current based, so if you follow it, it will really help you a lot. So that was the first thing that helped me. Second thing was, I made small groups of 4 or 5 people who were very sincere for the mains examination on WhatsApp, and one for optional and one for GS. And what we used to do was, we would try to put questions if any problem is coming to us or any question which we want other people to write answers on, and then everybody would write points or answers on those questions, and then other people in the group would evaluate. And this used to happen on a very daily basis. And this helped me in 2 areas. One, value addition on topics, and second, practicing and improving myself through answer writing, that even Vipin was saying, sharing with your friends. And also it helped me in boosting my confidence, because when everybody used to write, I used to write and I used to get appreciation, it made me write more answers and feel confident about myself. And third thing I used to do was, say last year there was a question in examination, I would take up that question, I would write an answer, and I would self-evaluate. I will read my answer and I'll try to analyze whether I have done justice to it or not. If I'm not happy with my answer, I'll try to write it again and ensure that yes, I'm happy and satisfied with my answer. So self-evaluation is also very important. So just keep one simple thing in mind, that you are not writing from your perspective. You are writing from an examiner's perspective. If you keep this in mind and practice accordingly, this will really help you a lot. You literally have to fetch marks from the examiner, and that's an art, and that you have to learn and develop over a course of time. Now, that was the general part. Now, let me come to my topic that I have to talk upon. One is sociology part of GS paper 1, and then ethics. If I talk about the sociology part of paper 1, as such, sociology itself is a whole subject, so I do not expect you to read a lot on it. If you look at the questions, then you will find there are basically two categories of questions that are coming from this part. One is very general questions on urbanization, poverty, women issues, etc. And second is slightly technical questions where they might use some technical jargons or might need some concept building related to sociology. For example, on family, like life cycle of a joint family was asked. On caste, like Dalit movement was asked. So what I feel overall is, don't try to spend a lot of time on reading a lot on sociology. You can do two things. One, class 11th and class 12th NCERT, basically just try to look on those important chapters related to family, caste, social problems, and society in general. Whatever you find relevant to it, you can refer to it. Or you can refer to some value-added material that is available in the market. These two things, I think, should suffice. Don't try to get deeper into it of understanding sociology really technically, because it's a very vast subject. Apart from it, if you actually want to refer any book, then Ram Ahuja's book on social problem is also decent enough if you want to read some particular selective chapters. Apart from it, I think whatever you're reading in current affairs, general studies, should overall suffice for you. So don't try to work out a lot more than this in sociology segment. Second area which I would like to talk on is ethics, where I am trying to make up questions related to philosophical part and other things. Ethics, I feel, is not a subject which wants to check your technical knowledge. It's a subject that wants to check how do you apply ethics in your personal life. And that is something that you have to portray in your answers. So when you're trying to study this subject, don't try to study this subject from a perspective that you have to learn all those thinkers, theories, and all those things. Learn it from a perspective that, yes, you have to apply all these things in ethics paper. So what to do overall? Firstly, you are referring your coaching material, or if you are taking some coaching, that is one material that you are going to use. Second, you can buy any basic book, lexicon, or say any other thing. Apart from it, don't try to read a lot on sociology. Try to think more on ethics. Try to think more on it. I'll give you some basic examples. What I did was, firstly, our syllabus has mentioned a lot of values. So I used to take up all those values one by one. Say integrity, accountability, selflessness. And after reading from a particular source, I would try to think what actually integrity means to me. And I would think of some examples related to integrity in personal and professional life. So like this, I tried to cover up on all these values which are there. That was the first thing. Second, apart from values, there are few topics, say emotional intelligence, attitude, social influence, etc. Again, I would refer to some particular book on these areas, but then I would not try to think that technically on these areas. Say if attitude is a topic, so then I would think what actually attitude means to me. How can we change attitude? Why do we need to change attitude? And then I would think of some context. Say if it's a gender issue, then how can we change attitude over there? What reward methods can be there? What punishment methods can be there? What methods of awareness and through knowledge inculcation can be there, through concentration and motivation can be there. So likewise, every topic in the paper, I would read and I would try to break it up into very simple, common layman's way and then try to jot down some points on that. And same I would do when I would write answers. And I'll give you brief examples over it. Say, for example, there is a question that came last year that what gives you happiness? Now you don't need to write that XYZ thinker has said this is happiness and this is how we get happiness. Or even don't write like a journalist, oh, when I play a sport, I feel happy. Or when I go and hang out, I get party, I feel happy. neither be generalist nor write very bookish. You have to use ethics in your answer and write very contextually. So if I would have to approach this question, I would try to link it with values. What makes me feel happy, I would write. If I fulfill my social responsibilities, I feel happy. I will give examples. If I perform my duties, I feel happy. I'll give examples. If I share with others, I feel happy. I will give examples. If I accomplish my personal goals, which also have a social relevance, I feel happy. So likewise, you have used ethics and real life and tried to write your answers. And that is exactly what you have to do. And second thing that you can do is link with contemporary initiatives that are being taking place to write your answers. For example, this year there was this question on environmental ethics. So when I was writing this answer, I took the example of Ganges. That on one way we symbolize as Mother Goddess, and on the other way we are trying to put every filth on it. Now government has realized the importance of environmental ethics and look at the initiatives we are taking to again rejuvenate Ganga. So like this, I try to relate it to contemporary examples. And even in case studies that are related to philosophical areas, I had a very simple approach. They are not looking for a technical answer. They're only looking for an ethical answer. So you have to use your common sense when you're trying to give an answer and think from the ethical perspectives rather than from a manager's perspective that, yes, I will do this. You are a leader, not a manager. So keep this thing in your mind and keep yourself in the shoes of a bureaucrat or whatever role that has been specified to you, and from that logic you have to look upon an issue. One thing. And second thing, don't try to show your knowledge over there. At times what people would do if there is a dilemma and there are say three or four different areas where it has been asked that will you choose option 1, 2, 3, or 4. What people would do, they will write merits 1, 2, 3, 4, demerits 1, 2, 3, 4. That is not has been asked. You are given a situation and you have to analyze the situation. And when you're analyzing a situation, it is not the number of points that is coming to your mind. It has to be context-based and situation-based. Even if you're writing one point, it has to be very, very, very specific to the crux and showing an ethical relevance in that option. Not a very general or specifically whatever you want to write. Don't try to do this thing in case studies. Overall, your writing matters a lot. So you have to practice a lot in case studies and as well in writing ethics answers, because it is not a knowledge domain area, it is a thinking domain area. So you have to keep your thinking words high, read and try to make very specific notes over it, and lastly practice answer writing on that. One more area I would just try to touch in brief, and then I think Athar would discuss more on that, was essay. Essay people generally don't practice a lot, because what they think is ki general studies mein jo padha hai wo to pad liya and wahi essay mein likhna hai. And yahi hota hai jab hum essay attempt kar rahe hote hain to we just think acha ye topic pe hame aata hai humne likh diya, and we feel happy yaar essay to bahut acha likh ke aaye the par number nahi mile. The same happened with me last year. I was very happy with my essay and I was like fod diya ab to pakka 150 se kam dega hi nahi, and when I got to know my marks it was 121. So I realized at that point of time ki essay is not just throwing your knowledge on a particular topic. Essay is about building a whole outline and structure and putting up your thoughts according to the framework of the question. So this is something we have to learn. And when I practiced this year, thankfully I was able to score well and I got 149 marks, and that was one big reason I was able to get a good rank. So right now I can say I might not be able to write another good essay if it comes generally, but two things I was able to do well that helped me. One, understanding and learning that how do we actually write and approach an essay. That was one thing we have to learn. And second, I went with some preloaded missiles with me. Say for example, there are 15-20 common topics that you will definitely find: education, women, science and technology, internet. Likewise, look at the last 30 years papers of essays and you will be able to figure out very, very, very general areas which comes very commonly. On those topics, I try to collect a lot of quotes On those topics, I try to collect examples, case studies, government initiatives, any book, movie, or anything that I could just flood it in my essay. So all that knowledge collection, information collection was one part I did a lot. And then I practiced it in my essays. This helped me. I would not discuss essay in detail. I would just try to talk on two things that I think is very important when you write an essay. Your essay has to be written very, very, very systematically. Right from the beginning to the end, it needs to have a very connected flow. That is very important and where we miss out. At times, we try to think of a lot of dimensions and just throw them in our essay. That does not matter. You write less dimensions, but ensure that whatever you are writing is very coherent, very logical, and is backed by a few examples or illustrations. Now, what do I mean by connectedness? Like this year, there was this topic on education without values makes us a clever devil. So right from introduction to end, I try to ensure that my essay is connected. So initially, I try to build a past context that when we had a Gurukul system, we focus on Shastra and Shastra, knowledge and values, and were able to produce complete personalities. But in today's context, how are we not able to focus on values, but focus on skills? So where are we missing out? Then when I was trying to build the context, I took the political scenario. There I talked about politics, bureaucracy. From there, I linked that not just the power centers, but even the business centers. Over there, I talked about how it is happening. Then I came to the civil society, how media, how NGOs are becoming clever devils. And then I came to the common masses. So this is the way I connected all the dimensions. And likewise, I connected my conclusion to it, that what can be the solution of the problem. So keep connectedness in your mind. And second, whatever you are writing, back it through examples, case studies, or something or the other which makes it more relevant. If I give you one example, if I am writing an essay on, say, social media, how it can be misused. So I want to highlight this topic of cyber terrorism, and I'm writing some abstract information. Nobody would be interested in it. But I can make it more informative and more interesting through some example. Like, I can say there is this movie called... I'm not able to recall the exact name. It was War in Mexico or something like this, where a lady sitting in the suburbs of Mexico is trying to control the whole terrorism activities of ISIL in Syria. So that shows the power of this invisible medium to create havoc in society. So this is how I can highlight the importance of cyber terrorism, how it is a negative aspect. So just try to use such examples and illustrations in your essay. So these are the two things, if you keep in mind, I think you will be able to do well. Rest, I think Athar will talk to you in detail. Lastly, I would say just one simple thing, that if you are looking for a big success, try to focus on small successes, and that you will get in your test series. I never thought I will be able to get a good rank in civil services, but the moment I started writing tests and I was able to do well, that was the first time I got a realization that yes, even I can do it. And test helped me in covering up my syllabus very periodically, writing answers, getting evaluated, getting confidence in. I think confidence is the key. When you feel it, you do it. So keep your attitude right and make right efforts, and I am sure you will do well. Thank you.